just a hit, so it's a hit and run. So we'll find out soon enough. End the day. And now I'm really regretting. Oh.
According to Mrs. Markham, I was supposed to spend all day thinking up the right words. But to my surprise, I did my best work when I shut my head off. I didn't even want to think why Laura decided we'd meet at 3 o'clock in the morning, and in a restaurant we'd never gone to. I didn't know what to tell her, and something tells me she's no more ready for this meeting than I am. By nightfall, I finally stopped worrying. The right words would come when they were needed. And if they don't come at all, then so be it. I've heard said, when you're knocked out by a single blow, you don't have time to feel any pain. Well, that's a lie. It's painful as hell. Every day I spent in that coma, the pain was unbearable.
Alright, sorry, I was eating during the cutscene. I wasn't expecting this to show up. What the fuck is this? What the fuck is... Oh. Oops. Wow, day 55 already. Okay. That's okay. 3 weeks going by? Oh, but shit, I need to work on making a lot more money then.
Yeah, I heard about that already. But what if they decide to spill it to the papers? We need to start thinking now about covering our asses. I know people who can deal with this, but they'll need at least a week. Plus, if we want to...
Lieutenant Stett, I'm sorry to interrupt you, but I have Jack Boyd on the line.
Who?
Jack Boyd, sir. He's calling from the hospital.
Gibson, I'll call you back. Don't do anything without my team. Jack, well, wow. I didn't know you were awake. Doctor said you could be in that coma for months, even years. How are you feeling?
Tell me who's in control, Martin.
I don't think I follow you.
For God's sake, Martin, tell me it's you running the department and not some stooge from the mayor's office.
Yes, Jack. I am performing the duties of the police chief, but the new man's coming on Saturday, Kevin Paulson.
Kevin Paulson?
Yes, it's the guy from
I know who Kevin Paulson is. Now listen carefully, Martin. I'm coming back to work. I'm Freeburg's police chief, and it's gonna stay that way for another 4 months. Now you get on the phone and do whatever needs to be done. You run into any problems, threaten them with the media, court, or blackmail. But I don't think they'll give you any trouble. The mayor knows it's easier to just wait until the winter than deal with a scandal. Oh, and assemble a press conference.
Listen, Jack, I know the truth is on your side, but you have to take into account...
Martin! How long since you transferred to my department?
Coming up on 5 years now.
How many times in the last 5 years have you come to my birthday party? How many times have you come to the farm when I had the boys over?
Never had the pleasure, but...
Never. Because you couldn't care less. And I don't care for you either, Stett. It wasn't me who appointed you deputy, and you wouldn't have been my first choice. But if you do ever come over to my house... You won't miss the big hole in my backyard. Garbage pit. You know, for old rubbish. A smelly hole filled with rotten furniture and other crap. So, Stett, if I even for a moment doubt your devotion, you'll go straight into that pile of trash. Maybe you'll get to catch up with some old friends. You remember Kendrick, don't you?
I'll schedule the press conference for tomorrow, all right, Jack?
The day after tomorrow. Tomorrow I'm going shopping.
Damn, Jack is not afraid to threaten people. I mean, I kind of like it. But, okay, so let's see. Now you have a new car. We hope it will help you fulfill all your secret dreams. Now you have new clothes. We hope they'll make you feel younger. Now you have a new hairstyle. We expect that this luxurious head of hair will easily convince everyone that you are a king among men. You now have a new attitude. From now on, you are a true warrior, one who will not suffer the idiots who stand in his way. You are independent and self-confident. Damn! One last detail is missing, fashionable sunglasses. They'll give a final touch to your new image, the image of the peerless tiger. So maybe, like, slight midlife crisis. Actually, maybe a little past midlife crisis. How old is Jack? Anyway, good morning. How can I help you? Thank you. I'll get what I need myself. Thank you. I'm used to making decisions without any assistance. Thank you. I know exactly what I want. Let's see. I like the shape of the yellow ones, but the color of the green ones more. We'll take the green ones. These glasses tell everyone that you'll stop at nothing. These glasses make it clear that a lot depends on the decisions you make. And these glasses bring out your hidden sexuality, so I don't need those. You'll stop. So I kind of get the feeling that, like, this decision matters. I'm gonna take the green ones. Now you have a new fashionable sunglasses. May they transform not only your appearance, but how you feel.
No, that would be too much.
Jack, what's with the outfit? You planning on...
The pit in the backyard, Martin. Always remember about the pit in the backyard.
Don't talk to anyone before the press conference starts. I'll try to get you on stage quickly. Kevin Paulson is here. He wanted to...
Jack! I hardly recognize you. That's quite an image for a man like you. An old dog with a new trick, right? We should see each other more often. How long has it been?
Last time I saw you, I fired you, Kevin.
Ha! You mean the day I resigned in protest over the corruption and lawlessness at your police department, right?
Yeah, repeat that shit often enough, someday you might start believing it.
You know, Jack, I'm glad that everything turned out so well. Unlike you, I've made good use of the past 7 years. My new construction company keeps getting jobs from the city, and we're doing really well. I have a new house, new hobbies, even a new wife. Maybe you've met her. Shelly Rogers.
Oh, Shelly Rogers. So you really are in bed with the mayor.
It's a dream come true. All my dreams have come true. Only one thing remains. To bring order to the Freeburg Police Department.
You being serious, Kevin?
I'm serious as ever, Jack. I'm the most serious man you know.
It's not often you see the past and the future Freeburg police chiefs at the same press conference. I hope you have time to talk, Kevin. There's something we need to discuss. Jack, the reporters, they're waiting for you.
My retirement plan somehow just got turned into a circus. Fortunately, I'm pretty good at swallowing swords and jumping through burning hoops. They all seem to like it.
All right. Good morning. Mr. Boyd, is that a new hairstyle? Yes. I feel like a different person, so I figured I'd look like one, too. Do you know the person who attacked you? Hard to say. Everything happened so fast that I couldn't see his face. I have to admit, it's possible that it was someone I know. City Hall has yet to give a definitive answer as to whether you'll be returning to your post. Do you believe Rogers will decide in your favor? Yes, of course, or doesn't matter what he... I'm gonna say it doesn't matter what he says, because fuck Rogers. I'm the damn police chief, and he can damn well get used to it. Do you think what happened to you somehow affected you? We'll see. Well, I guess. Let's wait a bit and find out. Clearly, it has affected him. Thank you. Alright, I think we'll go ahead and get to the point where we're choosing the records, but then I will need to stop for just a little bit. For you guys, it'll be 1 week. For me, it'll be like a couple of hours, but anyway. Jack Boyd recovers from head injury. Jack Boyd unable to name attackers. Police chief awakens from coma. Oh, new car. Wow. I'm too tired, I can hardly walk straight. Can I go home? Yes. Too tired, I can hardly walk straight. Can I go home? Yes. I'm sorry, I can't let you go. Oh, wow, he's really tired. Yes. I've got some terrible heartburn this morning. Might be better if... No. My friend crashed. No. Alright. And go ahead and give him the last one. Start the day. Oh! No records now, just cassette tapes. That's interesting. So when I come back, we will start checking out the cassette tapes and see what else has changed. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.